Hello, church. I'm so glad to have you here. Thank you for joining us in new reading plan, Walking Through Spiritual Valleys. We are on day two. The passages for today are more than two. For the sake of time, I will go with one. It is coming from 2 Corinthians 5:21. 2 Corinthians 5:21. I will read it with the ESV translation. For he made him who knew no sin to be sin for us, that we might become the righteousness of God in him. Amen. This is God's word. This verse should startle us and cause us to tremble. To be honest with you, it is not a verse to be read quickly and passed over. We'll never comprehend the great price that Jesus paid to cleanse us of our sin and to give us his righteousness. The prophet Isaiah summarized the human condition in this book. In his book, Isaiah 64:6, all of us have become like one who is unclean, and all our righteous acts are like filthy rags. So even the high priest Joshua, so here's Zechariah 3:3, and then he also, what he says, now Joshua was dressed in filthy clothes as he stood before the angel. So all these passages are telling us that our condition is doomed, right? And then also the Apostle Paul, who labored passionately and aggressively to be righteous before God, he later on realized that all his work with a great effort to please God were no more valuable than rubbish. In his book, Philippians 3:4-10, and he definitely made a testimony. What I did was no value at all. You know what? The plight of humanity is that regardless of who you are, no human's effort or any work could ever satisfy God's desire for righteousness. So we have to see the reality when it comes to the righteousness. Romans, you know, Apostle Paul, he goes in his books, Romans 3:10 says, no one is righteous, not even one. But the miracle of God's mercy is that God exchanges our filthy rags for fine garments of righteousness. Zechariah 3:4, the angel said to those who were standing before him, take off his filthy clothes. Then he said to Joshua, see, I have taken away your sin, and I will put fine garments on you. Amen. What does it say? Our sins are filthy, dirty sins have been replaced with a fine garments. How can this amazing thing be real in our life? How can we face this reality and make this truth real in our life? So only possibility for us to experience those truths is that look to Jesus. Meditate on him. Here's one guy who was called as one of Jesus' disciples. His name's Peter. He was at work casting a net as usual, but he couldn't catch many. That time Jesus approaching to him and came up to him and let him experience the miracle. And Peter ended up encountering Jesus Christ. This is what happened to Peter when he looked to Jesus. Luke 5:5. But when Simon Peter saw it, he fell down at Jesus' knees, saying, depart from me, for I am sinful man, O Lord. And now Peter says that this is a great moment. He was called by great teacher, Jesus Christ, Lord, our God. He called him personally, and then he says, go away from me, I'm a sinner. The more we come before him, the more we get close to him, we find out we are sinners. Right? When you see what God did and look to Jesus, we can finally face and deal with our sins. Also our inability not to do anything for our sins. But the moment when we see our inability dealing with our sins to be righteous before God, We find it unbelievable what God did for us through His Son, Jesus Christ. God the Father dealt with our sins through Jesus Christ. And then Jesus Christ was treated as a sinner on behalf of us. God the Father let Him die on the cross, Jesus Christ, His Son. We all know that that place, the cross, was where we were supposed to be. But by grace and His, God the Father's unending love, we are forgiven. So we can leave. When we feel apart from God, like we cannot feel His presence in this spiritual valley, the time is a time that we should look to Jesus. He is definitely evidence how much God loves us, how much He cares for us. Look to what God did. And to the passage definitely says that, for He made Him, Jesus Christ, who knew no sin, to be sin for us, that we might become the righteousness of God in Jesus Christ. In this awesome, amazing, unbelievable exchange, God placed the sin of humanity upon His Son, Jesus Christ, righteous one, became so identified with our sin. The scripture says that God made Him to be sin on our behalf. The Holy Son of God could not possibly do more for us than this. Experience the Father's wrath upon the sin He carried would have been more painful to endure than any human rejection or physical suffering. I hope and pray that never take the righteousness God has given you for granted. Never take the forgiveness of your sin lightly through Jesus Christ. Never, ever take what God did for your life to save you for granted. It cost God a terrible price in order to forgive us, love us, make us righteous, and make us His Son. Walk in a manner worthy of the righteousness He has given you. To live life in a manner worthy of Christian life. And today's day, you can see, you can look to Jesus so that you find out how terrible we are, how filthy our sin was, but we are cleansed by the blood of Jesus Christ. I hope and pray that you can experience God's grace and God's love towards you. Let's pray. Our Heavenly Father, thank You so much. You are a gracious Father. Because of You, because of Your grace, because of Your love, we are saved. Even though we are walking in the spiritual valley in this moment, in this difficult season, but we look to Jesus. And so that who was definitely evidence that how much You love us, how much You care for us, Lord. Jesus, thank You so much for Your grace. Thank You so much for Your cross. Lord, please help us to see and look to Jesus. And then we walk in the valley, and then we walk with the confidence, the fact that we are loved, we are saved by the grace of the Father and the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ. Be with us and bless us. We love You, Jesus. We thank You for Your cross. In the precious name of Your Son, Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.